Welcome to the Angular Input Mask tutorial. The Syncfusion Angular Input Mask, or Mask text box component, can mask and validate numeric values in standard input fields. You can let users enter valid data like phone numbers, date values, credit card numbers, and other standard format values. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Angular Input Mask component, with a few basic features like adding placeholders, data binding, and mask configuration. Let me start with the application creation process. I'm going to create an Angular application using the Angular CLI tool. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. First, open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the npm install -g at angular/cli command. As I have already installed it, I am skipping this step. Next, I will create a new Angular project. I use the ng new project name command and name my project example. I am creating a project with the option to add a CSS style sheet, so I choose the CSS option. The project creation has started, and it is creating an Angular project along with its dependencies. Now, let me navigate to the project folder to add the Syncfusion Angular Mask text box. Install the Syncfusion Angular Inputs package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularinputs --save command. This will install the package with its dependencies. The application is now ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. I open the main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To learn how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion components. Next, I navigate to the app component.ts file and import the mask text box module from the Syncfusion Angular Inputs package. Then, register it within the imports array of the component section. Move to the app component HTML file and remove its default content. I add a division element with a class wrapper. Inside this, add the mask text box component by adding the EJS mask text box element. I want to add a label here, so let me add a division element with a class label and set the label as a mobile number. Next, define the placeholder as enter a 10-digit number, which will be displayed as a hint in the mask text box. To apply styles to the mask text box, navigate to the styles.css file and add CSS references by importing the material theme. I also define the styles for the wrapper and label classes to align the component and label. Next, save the changes and run the application using the ng serve command. The mask text box component renders with a short description, enter a 10-digit number. To validate the user input, I should use the mask property. So I'll remove the placeholder property to show the standard mask values. I add the mask property and assign a standard mask element to enter a single-digit number ranging from 0 to 9. You can see that I can enter numbers between 0 to 9. Next, to add a value to the mask text box, I add the value property and assign a 9-digit number value. Now the mask text box component displays the given 9-digit number value. Next, I will show you how to set custom mask elements. For more clarity, I remove the value property. As I am going to display a time value, I set the custom characters property with the key fields as P and M. Also, I change the mask property to time to display the placeholder text in the mask text box, add the placeholder property with a text. I remove the division element here. See, I can enter the time based on the custom mask set to it. Next, I will show you how to set a regular expression. Before that, let me remove the custom characters property and set the float label type property to show the label on the top while typing the value. Here, I set its value to auto. I set an appropriate expression for this mask property to get the 4-digit ADM PIN number. Along with this, I change the placeholder text to enter PIN. See, I can enter only a digit range from 0 to 9. Next, to add prompt characters to the mask elements such as a hash, I set the prompt character property to hash. Look, a hash is displayed. Finally, I will show you how to bind native events to a mask text box. I'm going to show you a simple example using the click event. First, I add a button and set the button content to click. To apply styles to the button, I set the class names eButton and eInfo to it. Then, I add the click event and assign the change event handler. Next, in the app component TS file, I define the change method. Then, declare the state variable value and initialize it to 9999. Add the value property in the mask text box component tag and set its value using the value variable. To access this element on the button click event, I need its instance, so I add a reference attribute. Moving to the app component TS file, I first import the view child decorator to get the reference of the component. Then import the mask text box component from the Syncfusion Angular inputs package. Using the view child decorator, I get the reference to the mask text box element and create an instance for it. Inside this event handler, update the mask text box value to 2323. When I click the button, the mask text box value changes to the new static value passed inside the callback method. In this video, I showed you how to add this Syncfusion Angular mask text box component to an Angular application. I also showed you some basic features like data binding, mask configuration, and supported native events. To see a working example, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link to check if you qualify for a free license key to use our Angular products through our community license. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.